Hi guys, today we are talking about foods that contain vitamin C for diabetes. Yes, types foods rich in vitamin C, and we will talk about what it leaves vitamin C, and we will talk on how to get the maximum benefit from vitamin C from food. This is a 365 days healthy channel specializing in sharing free health knowledge. Please subscribe to our channel to receive the latest videos. And today we will learn about vitamin C. You are having trouble that your blood sugar will be high, and any time you are under stress your body needs more antioxidants, and their vitamin C will help there, it will help you. So let's dive into vitamin C rich foods first, and we'll take a look at some of the concerns, or I'll warn you with certain vitamin C things you need to know in order for you to know don't abuse it. First, vitamin C is found in berries, citrus fruits, green vegetables. Sources among the green vegetables are asparagus, tomatoes, avocados, the beets, currants, broccoli, Brussels sprouts, cantaloupe, collards, grapefruit, kale, lemons, mangoes, papayas, mustard greens, oranges, green peas, sweet peppers, persimmons, pineapple, radishes, spinach, strawberries, turnip greens, onions. For vitamin C to add to the growth and repair process, it helps with collagen formation, it helps your body's immune response, it's a great antioxidant to prevent cancer, and more, and it also helps with insulin resistance. Yes, most people go, when I say vitamin C, they go for fresh orange juice or orange juice, it's okay, but when you have diabetes can really affect you, so you have to be very careful. Be careful about how much sugar you get. But like I said, vitamin C is so common in many other foods, you don't have to drink that orange juice. Plus, we talked about this before, we don't want to make processed oranges, or I mean orange juice at all. If you take more than 500 milligrams of vitamin C, especially those using glucose sensors, you know that these sensors will sense you without using a finger dipstick, and that these people will be affected when taking more vitamin C than 500 milligrams per day tends to lead to high blood sugar. So don't overdo it, to never exceed 500 milligrams. Actually, who is really lacking in vitamin C right now? Yes, it's more likely to be the boys and girls who drink, and smokers are more likely than anyone else. If you're on pain medication, taking antidepressants, anticoagulants, birth control pills, all of these can deplete your vitamin C. And as a result, if you are taking these medications, you may want to use extra vitamin C, so be careful with this. When you overuse vitamin C, especially over 2000 milligrams, it can actually work against you and do the opposite. Instead of becoming an antioxidant, it creates oxidative damage. Many people use vitamin C to help prevent the common cold, but repeated studies show it doesn't really help much in preventing colds. But if you do get a cold and take extra vitamin C, can help reduce the number of days with colds. Assuming your common cold instead of 7 days, you can reduce it to 5 days. Chewable vitamin C should be avoided, as they can cause enamel problems, like gum line problems, so that's another thing I have to warn you about. But the bottom line in general is that getting around 100 milligrams of vitamin C, especially from the foods we've discussed, is certainly helpful if you do. You need vitamin C in moderation, servings of no more than 500 milligrams per day, and that may lower your blood sugar a bit, but not as much as anything. Either way, if you're particularly deficient, it can help make you insulin resistant. And we've already talked about other benefits and risks, so I hope that video helps.